don't turn your servant away. Oh Allah, I beg you to forgive me, for I have sinned, my ways I could not see. Now I stand before you, my Creator. Please don't turn your servant away.
Don't say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not forgive me. Don't say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept me. But be sincere. Sincerity is the condition we want. Honesty is the condition we want. Sincere tawbah. We should be after these feelings. I really, really want to stop the sin. Look at the conditions of tawbah. Just tawbah is not a word on the mouth. Repentance is not just a word a person says with his mouth. It's a heart feeling. It's a promise between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ulama say that tawbah is obligatory from every sin. The scholars say tawbah is obligatory. Repentance is obligatory from each and every sin you do. But it has conditions. The first condition is that the person stops the sin. يُقْلَعْ عَنِ الْمَعْصِيَةِ. To stop the sin. The second condition is to regret the sin. To have that feeling of regret in your heart. The sins that I have done before. To regret doing these actions. And the third condition is to sincerely and honestly promise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you will never return back to the sin again. These are the conditions of tawbah. If the sin has to do with something between you and your Lord, it has to do with you doing a sin between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A fourth condition is added. If the person has committed a sin that, for example, he has abused someone or stole something from someone, it has to do with one of the other slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you have, plus these conditions, you have to ask for his forgiveness. Give him back what you have stolen from him. If you, for example, have backbit him, go and seek his forgiveness. Apologize and say, brother, I have done this and this. Please forgive me. This is the fourth condition that's added if the sin has to do with you and any of the slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Please don't turn your servant away. Oh Allah, I beg you to forgive me. For I have sinned, my ways I could not see. Now I stand before you, my Creator. Please don't turn your servant away.
The first question any of us will be asked on Judgment Day will be about what? About your salah. The first question on that fearful day, on that hard day when everyone is suffering, everyone is struggling, everyone is in fear, not knowing where is he going, to paradise or to hellfire. The first question in the test is what? How was your salat? How did you deal with this order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How did you handle salat? What was the quality of your salat? أول ما يسأل عنه المرء يوم القيامة يسأل عن صلاته. The hadith continues. فإن صلحت, if his salat was a pass, if it was good, فقد أفلح وأنجح. Then this person will be successful on that day. Will be successful on that day. فإن صلحت فقد أفلح وأنجح. And if it is not successful, if this test is not a pass, if your salat is not a pass, فقد خاب وخسر. Then this person is verily a loser. Is a loser on that day. Look at the difference between us and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When we come to prayer, how do we feel? What are our feelings? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, وَجُعِلَتْ قُرَّةَ عَيْنِي فِي الصَّلَاةِ. The coolness of my eyes is where? Is in salat. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to enjoy this ibadah. He did not handle this ibadah of salat as an obligation that he has to finish and fulfill and get over and done with, like many of us do. When Fajr prayer comes, Dhuhr prayer comes, how do we handle it? And now I have to pray. Even people that pray, now I have to pray. He comes quickly, you know, yanquruha naqran, as the hadith says, like a bird, you know, picking seeds off the floor. quickly, ruku', sujood, runs through his salat, finishes, and then you wake up, you're back to the world. When you finish this dream, you say, Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah, Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah, and you are alive again. But in salat, you are daydreaming. Daydreaming. You start your salat, there's no concentration. There is no devotion. There is no enjoying. You don't enjoy the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't enjoy speaking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't enjoy hearing the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a calamity. It's a disease that is extremely dangerous. And the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has to work on this disease to fix this problem. The problem of khushu' and the problem of understanding the importance of this ibadah.
And guiding me each and every day.
Imagine Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is speaking to people that he loves. People of the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he loves. إِنَّ مِنْ أَحَبِّكُمْ إِلَيْهِ The most beloved of you to me and the closest of you to me on Judgment Day. وَأَقْرَبِكُمْ مِنِّي مَجْلِسًا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ Those that will be close to me on Judgment Day. أَحَاسِنُكُمْ أَخْلَاقًا أَحَاسِنَكُمْ أَخْلَاقًا People that have good manners. وَإِنَّ مِنْ أَبْغَضِكُمْ إِلَيْهِ وَإِنَّ أَبْغَضَكُمْ إِلَيْهِ Those that I detest the most of you, I hate the most of you. وَأَبْعَدَكُمْ مِنِّي مَجْلِسًا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ And are the furthest away from me on Judgment Day, الثَّرْثَارُونَ وَالْمُتَشَدِّقُونَ وَالْمُتَفَيِّقُونَ The arrogant, the pompous, people that harm others with their tongues, harm others with their attitude and their arrogance and their kibr. These people, in the nearest meaning of the words of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam detests them. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam hates these people and they are the farthest away from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on Judgment Day. Now look at the reward of having good manners. When the person controls himself, has this good conduct, he is close to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on Judgment Day. And where is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on Judgment Day? Beside the Hawd, Al-Kawthar. Allah Akbar, Inna a'tainaka Al-Kawthar. Beside the Hawd of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be the people that worked on themselves, worked on the habits and the attitudes and the manners until they elevated themselves from the bad qualities that human beings develop and bring in this world because of greed and hasad and envy and lack of ability of sacrifice, lack of ithar and so on and so forth. These people have elevated themselves, so they deserve to be beside Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on Judgment Day. What an honor and what a rank!